Good morning, Kahal Kadosh. Tisku l'shanim rabot, everyone, in this day, Thursday, Tzom Gedalia, the third day of Tishrei, the 9th of September 2021. Today's class graciously sponsored by Mr. Uri Jamal and family, Le'ilui Nishmat, his beloved father, Kamel Ben Nuzha, alav shalom. Iratzon that to the words of Torah, his neshama will have an aliyah in Gan Eden. Amen. We hope and pray that everybody, wherever you may have been, had a beautiful and uplifting Rosh Hashanah. I believe that all of us who prayed here had a beautiful holiday, correct? Beautiful. You enjoyed the holiday? How was the shofar, the musaf, sefer, good, all good?
On time.
On time, and we finished early. That was the biggest miracle of all.
Yes, exactly.
And I know the secret. Because we pre-sold everything. So this way we did not invest time in the sales. That for some people is very exciting, but it does make a difference.
Huge
difference, I think, and the overwhelming response of the Kahal has been great. So we are thankful to Hashem for such a beautiful beginning of the year. But today, like it or not, it is not a very happy day. Today is called the day of Ta'anit of Tzom Gedalia. Just to give you basic historical background, what prompted this Ta'anit? This Ta'anit was established by our holy rabbis after the destruction of the first Beit HaMikdash. Nebuchadnezzar destroys basically the Beit HaMikdash, and a lot of Yehudim were sent into exile. Thousands of them. But obviously Nebuchadnezzar wants to go home, and he wants to make sure that there is a reliable person to be running, let's call it, the show in Yerushalayim. Who are you going to appoint? They appointed a great person, a great Yehudi, by the name of Gedaliahu ben Ahikam. He was a righteous person, a holy person, a trustworthy person who politics for him did not change him. We know politics not all the time is very clean. Regretfully, it's completely the opposite. But Nebuchadnezzar saw in Gedaliahu ben Ahikam to be the right person for that position. And to a certain extent, that brought certain, peace of mind and tranquility to the Jewish people, because they had someone of their own running the city of Yerushalayim. But parallel to that, there was, and I have here some of the historical background, and it says as follows, that after the destruction of the Beit HaMikdash, the majority of the Jewish people were exiled from Eretz Israel. With the exception of a handful, were allowed to remain behind. How many? 6,000 families only. 6,000 families in a country that had millions is not much. How many people 6,000 families can represent? 20,000 people? Let's say, let's be generous, 30,000 people? 30,000 people to run a country, it's almost impossible. The country is too big for 30,000 people. So what was the purpose of leaving these people behind? So it says, La'avod et admod ha'ares, to work the land, to produce the fruits of the land, the grains of the land, etc., and to collect the tax for the kingdom. Okay? So nobody escaped taxes. Now, it comes the great Gedaliahu is appointed to make sure that has Eretz Israel is stable. But what was the miracle that happened? So it says as follows, that when people saw that Gedaliahu ben Ahikam was the mayor of Yerushalayim, many people that went and escaped Israel by going to different lands, they decided to come back to Eretz Israel. Beautiful. But regretfully, the world there was the kingdom of Ammon. Ammon and Moab, they were two sworn enemies of the Jewish people. Ammon and Moab were the children born from Lot. Remember the story of Lot in Sefer Bereshit after the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah? So Ammon and Moab always had an eye of the land of Israel. And they saw a great opportunity to attack Israel and to remove the Jewish families and to remove Gedaliah, because they figure if the bulk of the Babylonian empire and kingdom left Israel, so to conquer Israel should be something very easy and very doable. This is the historical background, and to the point that the king of Ammon selected a Jew by the name of Ishmael ben Netaniah. This Ishmael ben Netaniah was a troublemaker. Let's call him the Jewish underground. He wanted to stir the pot. He saw the appointment of Gedaliah as a moment of decision making in the history of the Jewish people. And he puts a goal into his mind, how to get rid of Gedaliahu. Gedaliahu was warned, be careful, we suspect there could be an attempt in your life by this Jew by the name of Ishmael ben Netaniah. What was the reaction of Gedaliah when he was told this piece of information? You know what was his reaction? I don't want to hear Lashon Hara. Don't tell me. I don't want to hear Lashon Hara. Sadiq, what happens? So it says that Gedaliah, he failed to accept it, and regretfully comes Ishmael ben Netaniah on today's day, a day of the third of Tishrei. Gedaliah like wants to salute Ishmael, hugs him, and in that moment Ishmael kills Gedaliahu plus all the people that were with him. There's two opinions and that discuss what exactly happened or when did exactly happen. One opinion says that this happened actually on the first day of Rosh Hashanah. But in order not to taint the day of Rosh Hashanah with a tragedy, our Hachamim transferred the Ta'anit on a day like today, on Thursday, which we're going to ask a question from the Ben Ish Chai. So it says here that Ishmael killed all the people that were together with Gedaliahu. But regretfully, this tragedy, it continued. The Gemara in Masechet Nidah says that although Gedaliahu was a righteous man and he refused to listen to Lashon Hara, the Gemara doesn't be in accordance with Gedaliahu's approach. If, God forbid, somebody tells you, be careful because this person wants to get rid of you, are you going to ignore such a comment?
No.
And especially there was a known fact that this Ishmael ben Netaniah was a Jewish terrorist, that the Hachamim were not happy with his actions. Because what he wanted to do? He wanted to stir the pot. The similar incident happened after the miracle of Hanukkah, that there was a rebellion against the Torah by the Jewish people. by the kingdom that preceded, that followed rather, the miracle of Hanukkah. So bottom line, it says here that the Gemara brings a very interesting statement. And listen to the words. Be'abor asher ishlich sham Ishmael et kol pigre anashim asher hika be'yad Gedaliahu. The pot, the hole where Ishmael put all the remains of the people that were killed by Gedaliah. As the Gemara, Bechi Gedaliah haragan, Ishmael haragan. Why are you blaming Gedaliah, Hazid? Gedaliah was a victim. Ishmael killed him. The Gemara says, no, he should have been concerned on the warning that Yohanan ben Kareyah gave him, and if he would have listened, perhaps him and the other people that were killed would have been alive, because we'd be on the defensive. Can you imagine yourself, you think the Secret Service ignores threats? They are look at the lookout. Even if they smell, God forbid, that it could be any kind of attempt, what they do? They shut it down. They are proactive. They're willing to take a bullet for the president, Hamavdil. So it says that he wanted Ishmael, his thirst for power, didn't stop with the killing of Gedaliah. You know what was his next plan? He says, if I kill the head, Gedaliah, now the Jewish people, they are like a car without a driver. I'm gonna take them all, and I'm gonna deliver them to become slaves to Ammon. And therefore, when Yohanan ben Kareah became aware of this, so he let the Jewish people know, leave the land of Israel. Why? Because so far, we did not discuss the reaction of Nebuchadnezzar. He did not have Instagram or WhatsApp message. Hey, Nebuchadnezzar, Gedaliah was killed. No, they needed to send a messenger to arrive to Babylon, to arrive to Iraq, and to let them know, and then wait for the reaction. So these few days that they had, the Jewish people abandoned the land of Israel, and the land of Israel became completely abandoned and desolated. This took place after the destruction of the Beit HaMikdash. Now, what comes,
where did they go?
All over. Whatever countries they were able to come in, you know, like now they're sneaking out people from Afghanistan, Hamavdil, okay, probably that's exactly what they did. They went to different places. The first country that opened the doors, they went and they settled there. Now, exactly, so I'm going to discuss now. So the question is, why do we fast? If the Ben Ish Chai asks an interesting question, the Ben Ish Chai says, throughout history, we had had days that great tzaddikim passed away. For example, we have Asara Haruge Malchut, the 10 martyrs that were executed tragically after the destruction of the second Beit HaMikdash. Rabbi Akiva, Rabbi Ishmael Kohen Gadol, Rabban Shimon ben Gamliel, just to name a few out of 10. And we don't do a fasting because of their tragic passing. But yet for some Gedaliah, we do. What's the difference between the fast of some Gedaliah and the rest of the Tzaddikim that were murdered? Says the Ben Ish Chai, one simple difference, that all these Tzaddikim were killed by Goyim, and Gedaliah was killed by another Jew. Ishmael ben Netanyahu was a Jew, was a Jewish terrorist. So listen to the Balaita, and it says, Mehila, the Rabbeinu Menachem Azariah Mipano. So it says, Miyom Shenisraf HaBet HaMikdash, just chronologically, The first Beit HaMikdash was destroyed on the 9th of Av. 52 days later, Gedaliah was killed. So it says 52 days, like the numerical value of the word Gedaliah. If you add together Gimel, Dalet, Lamed, Yod, He, gives you 52. And that's what the Gemara writes in Masechet Rosh Hashanah. Shekula mitat asadikim keserefat bet Eloheno. It says, it's equally tragic to the Almighty the passing of a righteous like the destruction of the temple. Like the 52 years that we went out, as the Pasuk writes in the book of Tehillim. And it says the Rambam, Yesh Yamim, there are days in the Jewish calendar that we fast for the tragedies that transpire. Kedei le'orer ha'levavot, in order to activate the heart of the person and to open the pathways of Teshuvah. So the question that you may ask is, what days, in other words, what is the day that I need to avoid situations like in today's day? Says the Rambam, Yom Shelishi Betishrei, Shevo Neherag Gedaliah Ben Ahikam. It says, Gedaliah Ben Ahikam was killed by another Jew. It wasn't a victim of an explosion or an accident or a building or an airplane. Literally, was killed by another Yehudi. And if God forbid, the Rambam seems to imply that a Jew can reach the lowest level of killing another Jew, that's enough reason to fast. Let's clarify. Today, we kill people, God forbid, without physical actions. Today, you kill the character of the person, right? In English, it's called defamation of character. Or Mosi Shemra. Or God forbid, a Jew is accused falsely by another Jew. Or another case, Levayesh. Levayesh means to embarrass. Embarrassing someone, it's equal to killing somebody. And that's why it seems on the Rambam that it says that the Avodah of these days are also Ben Adam LaHavero. That the Avodah, the holy service of these days, is the enhancement and the improvement between people. Besides our godly relations that comes with the changes, for example, of Tefillah, right? Today you added Avinu Malkeinu. We added Shira Ma'alot. We added Hashem Hu Elokim before Hashem Melech. And we also make the basic changes in the Amidah. Zocher Lechaim, Michamocha, Ose HaShalom, HaMelech HaKadosh, HaMelech HaMishpat, Uchtov Lechaim Tovim, Ufsefer Chaim Berachah B'Shalom. All these changes were added by our holy rabbis in order to reinforce the idea and the concept of Hashem's kingdom in the world. And that's why we say HaMelech HaKadosh, HaMelech HaMishpat. Even though we say every day of the year HaKel HaKadosh, that means the Holy Almighty, but in this case we say HaMelech, just to remind ourselves that in these 10 days we're crowning Hashem as the King. And therefore the Halacha calls these days Aseret Yemei Teshuvah, even though that from today till Kippur we only have 7 days. But interesting enough, the Halacha writes that we also add Rosh Hashanah, 2 days, plus Kippur, 1 day. Then we have Aseret Yemei Teshuvah. So we have 2, 7, and 1. And there are 10 days of Teshuvah that we try to remedy as much as we can, learning from the different Pesukim. Now, what's this idea of Aseret Yemei Teshuvah? It says very simple, is a gift from God. And listen to the beautiful Lashon that it says, Be'avat Hashem et Amo, ki hafez chesed hu, out of the great love that God has for Am Israel, and God wants to do always good, Be'lo yachpos be'mot hamet, And God doesn't look for the disappearance of the wicked one. Kim Beshubomi Darkoba Haya. God wants the person to enhance their behavior, to improve their actions. Lachen Mamtin Hu Umsapel Teshubata Hotim. Bore Olam eagerly waits our return. And when does he wait for our return? Comes the Pasuk in Yeshaya that says, Dirshu Hashem Beimaseo. Look for God and you will find them. Kera'uhu biyoto karov. Call upon him when you are close to him. So it says, what are the days? So it says, the Sefer HaToda'ah, sometimes God is easier found than others. And these 10 days are the 10 days that perhaps we can say is the ultimate manifestation of Hashem's presence in the world in these days of Teshuvah. And even though we have a rule that says Teshuvah doesn't have a time limitation, you can do Teshuvah any day of the year. You can do Teshuvah any hour of the day. You can do Teshuvah any day of the week. But there are certain days that you get a free upgrade. Okay, they tell you if you go to 7-Eleven, on 7-Eleven, you get a free Slurpee. Have you heard of that?
Yes.
Okay, I'm sure your kids know of this. Very good, right? Right, 7-Eleven gives you a free Slurpee. Hamavdil ben Kodesh Lechol, Aseret Yemei Teshuvah is the day that the doors are widely open and Borei Olam welcomes the Teshuvah of the person. And for this reason, in Aseret Yemei Teshuvah, we have longer Selichot. We add a few extra paragraphs and the Lacha writes that even on the things that a person perhaps is not always cautious and meticulous, especially when it comes to the loss of kashrut, etc. Nevertheless, the Halacha says, go the extra mile. Show HaKadosh Baruch Hu that you are developing the potential, and therefore, according to some opinions, the person should have a Chol HaMoed schedule of work. What does it mean? Work a bit less, learn more Torah, do more tzedakah, read more Tehillim, do more tefillah, so we concentrate on the goals that we have. And that's why there are those who are meticulous of paying all their debts before Kippur. Interesting concept. Why? Shelo yimsa harehem kitrug kelal. So there will not be any kind of accusation lingering. Look at this guy. He leases $1,000 a month car and doesn't pay the bills of the synagogue. Hamavdil, I'm only bringing this type of example. I hope that no one is paying $1,000 in a lease of a car. Maybe two cars, okay? Two cars. Your wife needs a minivan probably, and you need a car. So, okay, but $1,000 for one car? I hope you're just laughing because you like what I'm saying. All right. Baruch Hashem. Baruch Hashem, I didn't believe that you will do such a thing.
But the prices today are going up.
Yeah. Unbelievable, because you have no cars. Because you have no cars. Now they suddenly are going to stop production because they don't have all the computer, the chips, right? The computer chips. So imagine yourself, what does that do? It first of all increases the prices of the vehicle tremendously, supply and demand. But yes, you're right. And that's why in one of the Yehida sonnets that we said yesterday, we said the word Yoker HaShe'arim, Hashem protect us from inflation. Hashem protect us from inflation. You know, we read the Yehida son, okay, Yoker HaShe'arim. Now suddenly these words now make sense. Magefa, pandemic, a plague, famine, war, natural disasters, cost of living and inflation. In the Eiratzon of the opening of the Ark.
Yeah.
Unbelievable, who would have thought that now these words are coming alive?
They mean much more.
So it means that we need to pray a lot.
Yeah.
We need to pray much more. But we also need to remember that we are in the year of Shemitah, the very special year in Eretz Israel. the land of Israel goes into a sabbatical mode, already started, and definitely is a challenge. But as I said, the night in Rosh Hashanah, for the first time in Jewish history, since the destruction of the second Beit HaMikdash, that more than 50% of the farmers are resting in the year of Shemitah. It's a big zechut for Am Yisrael. You know why? The Mishnah in Pirkei Avot writes, you want to know why Galut exists? Because we don't observe the Shemitah laws. The Mishnah in Pirkei Avot, clear, black and white. Pirkei Avot clearly states that because we fail to observe Shemitah in Israel, we go to Galut, meaning to say, if we don't treat the land of Israel with the proper level of holiness, so what are we doing? We are God's ambassadors, not only to the world, but also to the land of Israel. So whatever happens in Israel, it definitely has a direct influence, not only in the world, but actually in our life.
Sure.
So definitely it's a big zahud for those who observe Shemitah, which is not easy. A year.
Wow.
Can you imagine not going to work for 1 year?
Wow.
And you still have to pay the lease of the tractor, you have to pay all the equipment, you have to pay everything that you have ongoing to run your business.
Yeah, they don't get PPP.
They don't get PPP. But you know what they get? They get a grant from people.
Beautiful.
There are a few organizations that put together millions, I don't know how many, but millions of dollars just to give the coverage to the needs that each farmer has.
Wow.
I do not know how much that represents, but figure. You have a tractor is not the cost of a lease.
No. That's $5,000.
That's a few thousand a month.
Yeah.
And they don't forgive you.
No.
You gotta pay it. But if you have no income, how are you going to pay it? So this is where we come into the place. Yehudim from outside of Israel, and maybe some in Israel, but most of the support comes from outside of Israel, to support the farmers which are observing the mitzvah of Shemitah, which is a great zechut that it's happening. And definitely, we hope and pray that Mashiach will come in no times. Okay, my good friends, so we leave the class here today. Very nether tomorrow. We'll start a bit earlier since the tefillah was much longer than usual, so we'll be able to discuss some of the halachot and some of our due diligence in these days of Aseret Yemei Teshuvah. Everybody have an easy fast, Be'ezat Hashem.